I came across another one of these free energy spring engine type videos, and I looked for how the video was manipulated to make it look like it works, and I can't figure it out. So I thought, why don't I just build one like that and see how it works? I'll start with some coat hanger wire to try to make it a crankshaft. It's tricky to make that crank small and accurate enough, but it worked out okay. And in the video I saw the flywheel was this big ball bearing. I don't have one like that, so I'm just gonna make that out of a block of heavy hardwood. And trying to make the edges all smooth on the belt sander. But then I put on my metal lathe to make it perfectly round, and I also milled the sides to look a bit more like a ball bearing. And then drilling some holes in the sides to make it look more like a ball bearing, which it turns out is actually quite important to make this thing work. And trying to flywheel on the crankshaft, I still have to bend that crankshaft a little bit to adjust it. And I'm just running the coat hanger wire straight in holes in blocks of wood. I don't have any small ball bearings like that kicking around. I guess that spins true enough now. And now I'm attaching the springs, although if I wanted to make this like one of the typical spring engine videos, I shouldn't be narrating it, because they're mostly made in Spanish-speaking countries, but targeting English-speaking countries. And let's give it a spin. Holy crap. It works. Holy crap. I gotta try to make some electricity with this thing. Got a little generator with an LED on it. And now let's add a belt. Wow, that's lighting up pretty good. And this video is not manipulated in any way, seriously, straight off the camera. So, we're gonna come clean with how this machine actually works. Let me rewind. So, we're gonna come clean with... And you know how I hinted that the look of this flywheel is actually kind of important? Let me show you why. So, while recording this, at some point I had to step on this thing here. That turns on this blower, and it comes out of here, and that was just out of frame. That's the wrong way. And that powers the machine pretty good. And if I blow the air just at the outside of the flywheel, that doesn't grab it enough, so this texture on here is really important. And the other video with the ball bearing also wasn't smooth here because he's got the balls in there. And of course, what's also really important is that it runs fairly well on its own for quite a while. So if I take the belt off, these springs are the softest springs I had. They're really thin wire, but they're large enough diameter so they look like they might be doing something. So, like this, it runs for quite a while. Now, while I was building it, I showed spinning it up and it spun down fairly quickly. That's because I jammed the sliver of wood inside the bearings deliberately to make it slow down more quickly. Otherwise, if you could see it spin so long on its own, that would be rather unconvincing, wouldn't it? And this nozzle originally was just like this, but I found I'd see too much of a shadow from it like that, so I had to extend it a little bit so that the shadow is less noticeable. I also changed the lighting, so I put a bright lamp here, and I used to have a lamp right here, turned that off so that there'd be less of a shadow in frame like this. You don't really notice that there's any shadow from this thing, whereas if it was up close like this and the light behind it, then the shadows become noticeable. And it would have been easier to just use an air compressor for this, but my air compressor doesn't have a big enough tank to sustain volume like that. So just using this blower worked out okay and not quite as loud. Of course, it's still way too loud, and even the air whistling out of the jet would have been too noisy, so I had to dub over different audio for when the engine was running. And that was just done by recording it close up and spinning the engine up by hand. And I had to splice a whole lot of clips of that together because the engine doesn't run for that long. So I was being totally honest when I said the video wasn't manipulated early. The audio, of course, was, but I didn't say anything about the audio. And the whole thing started with somebody challenging me to debunk this free energy video, and I had a look at it very carefully, and I just could not find the place where the video was manipulated. So I figured it must be powered by something, but when you look at the construction of this video, the tools the guy's got at his disposal, he's not going to be able to fit a little motor inside the hub there or something like that. So it had to be something else, and then I realized it's got to be air blown at the thing. But the only direct tell of that is right here in the video. See that dust flicking around back and forth? That's from wind, because of course he needs some wind to spin up the flywheel. And using that big ball bearing for a flywheel keeps it going even if it's not directly in the wind for a few seconds. So that helps a lot. My hardwood flywheel doesn't have quite as much inertia, but it's a little bit bigger, so it helps too. And I also mentioned these videos seem to mostly be coming from Spanish-speaking countries like South America or the Philippines. And why is that? Well, the currency is a lot lower for those countries, and if you can make a video that does well in North America, you're going to do fairly well with AdSense money, and that is probably very competitive with other earnings opportunities in places like the Philippines. This video, for instance, which I debunked earlier on my other channel, I'm pretty sure is from the Philippines. And funny enough, by now my video debunking this spring engine has got more views than his video on spring engines has done quite well on AdSense, so I can understand why these people keep making these videos. And this guy has now made a video, in fact this video right here, debunking all these other spring engines, and I'm like, oh, he's finally come clean. But no, first he says, oh, these don't work, and then he's explaining, well, mine is different and this is why mine works. Yeah, right. I don't think I'll bother debunking his debunk video, because if you watch my video explaining how he's done the video and watch this one carefully, works the same way. Basically, video cuts and compositing. That's how he tricked this one. I quite liked this one in that it was done without video trickery. Like seriously, no video trickery. It's just the nozzle is just slightly off screen. So it's simple, it actually runs. The only thing the guy had to do is fake the sound. And if you look at like when he first starts it, that sound doesn't make sense for what's happening on the screen. But you know, as a video creator, I actually feel a certain sense of camaraderie with these guys, in that they're just trying to make a buck and trying to make videos. It's too bad it's about peddling something that's dishonest. That part I don't like so much, but I'm like, you know, if I can cash in on this free energy thing and debunk them at the same time, it's like, I'll definitely do that. And debunking that other free energy spring engine has worked out well for me so far. And looking at what I've got so far, I'm just past the 8-minute mark. And that's important, because if you're over 8 minutes, you get to have mid-roll ads in your video, and that means it earns more. And all those free energy videos? Over 8 minutes. Every single one of them. Because it's about the ad money.